I believe Trump is right. I think we should reopen schools. You said you're undecided. Let's see if I can change your mind.
Sure. Yeah, I'm not really sure. You know, I'm not well informed enough right now to see where it should go.
I believe that what we're seeing right now has become political. If you'd like me to dig into reasons why I believe it's political for like LAUSD suggesting no in-school teaching, I can let you know that. Also, I believe pushing for, they're calling it distance learning. Pushing for distance learning is ignoring science.
Yeah.
I think it's ignoring psychology. I think it's ignoring economics. And I think it's ignoring the very issues at hand when it comes to children not receiving the proper education at these crucial years in their lives. I think it ignores the importance of academics, and I think a lot of it's politically charged more than based on reason and facts.
So what about, how is it politically charged? I mean, they're still going to be getting an education. They're going to be doing remote learning. What's the difference?
A massive difference. Remote learning is nowhere near effective compared to in-school learning. When it comes to in-school learning, it's not just academics, although that's super important. And that's lagging when you're doing remote learning for children. Children don't learn as well when they're remote learning. But two, there is social and emotional education that children get by being in schools. There's physical activities. And then also not just that, but a benefit for a lot of underprivileged children that a lot of us tend to ignore a lot or just not look at. Underprivileged children, a big thing is nutrition as well from schooling. I'll just add one more thing on top of that. Teachers are the majority of individuals that report child abuse, neglect. In April or March and April, we saw a 40% plummet in areas and counties in New York, all across the nation. 40% plummet in reports for child abuse and neglect. Now, officials aren't celebrating that because they know why that is.
Right, it's not just disappearing. Right?
Because the children are not the children are not in front of educators' eyes, coaches' eyes, all that stuff like they normally are. There's over 670,000 reports of child abuse and neglect annually. The last thing that we want to do is turn this health pandemic into an abuse epidemic with people not reporting child abuse. You were saying, I don't think it's political. LAUSD has announced already that before they open back up...
Remote learning, right? They already said, like, without a doubt, it's going to be remote learning. Yeah.
There's only one option there, is remote learning. But before they open back up, they want a wealth tax. They want to defund the police. They want funding for illegal immigrants and their families. They want to suspend private schools. They want all these things. And that's where I say, okay, is it about the kids or is this on a political agenda?
As for children in schools,
they have virtually zero risk when it comes to COVID-19.
I think the issue is if they get it or they're carrying it, it can be passed on to the elderly.
So they're not, I understand your point there, they're not good at getting the virus and they're not good at transmitting the virus either. So Germany just did a study, the Dresden University of Technology just did a study. They went to schools with outbreaks. Obviously, you're a teacher, you know children, they touch everything, right?
Yeah.
When it comes to, they went to schools with outbreaks and they found, I think it was about 12 individuals with antibodies. They took thousands of blood tests and they had 12. And what that suggested, and there's plenty of other studies like this, what that suggested is kids don't get the virus. And if they get it, they don't really transmit it because they went to schools with outbreaks. And there was virtually nobody.
I don't know what kind of people have gotten out here today. It's like two ends of the spectrum where send them without any sort of regulations to help keep them healthy or just don't send them back at all.
I'll address that, okay. What studies are showing and what the hard data is showing when it comes to cases and deaths among children under the ages of 18 years old is showing that children do not get COVID they're not good at getting COVID. They're not good at transmitting COVID either. Okay, so we'll talk really quick about just the total numbers. In California, there's 8.9 million children under the ages of 18 years old in California. Can you guess how many have died from COVID?
None? Has it been none?
It's zero. So children, they don't transmit the virus very well, and they also don't get the virus very well. They're just, I don't know, it's just not affecting them. There are other respiratory diseases that do affect children. Yeah. COVID is not one of them.
I know children, they don't die from it. The only issue that I had was that it was going to be transmitted, or that if there were older administrators or people who had to go into school.
So they're not good at transmitting the disease.
Yeah.
Now, when it comes, I'm not suggesting don't be careful. I'm not suggesting don't be careful on on campuses. Teachers need to be careful. They need to, especially if they have comorbidities, stuff like that. But when it comes down to
elderly living at home,
very correct. Do you support maybe an option for parents? Hey, if you have a grandparent that lives in your house, you don't need to come to school and you can do online learning. That's fine. But an option for children, instead of saying all online learning, you can give them an option whether they want in-person or online. Do you agree with that?
I think that's where we have middle ground. I agree. You could give them an option. But see, here's the thing, though. I don't think correct me if I'm wrong. Doesn't he want to open it in August? He wants them to open in August, right? Trump said
Yeah. School's open. Like, the next couple months, okay, they'll be opening. August and September, they open.
Do you think in, the 18th? Do you think in 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 weeks that they can have social distancing measures in place, have a mask requirement, all that in 5 weeks?
5 weeks?
Yeah, 5 weeks.
Do I think so? Yes, absolutely. I think we can all get masks. I think that's very doable. In fact, the only people that would be really, quote, at risk or have a chance of you know, getting sick is like the rest of us. How about people that work at gas stations? How about people that work at grocery stores? How about all these people? Are they more essential than a teacher in teaching our children?
Yeah.
I actually do support giving parents the option to send their kids to school or distance learn, because like what you just said, you just brought up a fantastic point.
Yeah.
Or if you have elderly at home, you should not be forced to be sending your kid to school. Is that correct?
Yeah, no, I mean...
Do you support giving them the option?
How I would like to see it be... All right, no, you asked, do I support... Yeah, no, I think people should have an option.
What about teachers?
Let's get them back in. What was that?
What about teachers?
Like, how, for their risk?
Yeah.
What about gas station workers?
No, I'm just asking. What about
grocery store workers?
No, I know.
Teachers have to be a little...
I don't have all the
teachers
answers,
have to. Teachers have to be careful, but children don't get and transmit COVID like adults do. So they really have to watch out for adults instead of... we're going to walk
all
with you.
Other kids?
Instead of kids, correct.
Okay. That makes sense? Yeah.
These parents don't have these resources to put up with this. And when it comes to the risk of the students, it's virtually zero. Can you guess how many children under the age of 18 years old have died in California from COVID?
Probably less than 10.
Zero.
Wow, okay.
The one thing I think everybody can agree with is I really feel for the class 2020, the high school graduating class, right? I think everyone across the board will agree that high school prom, high school graduation, those are really important, you know, milestones, especially when you're 17, 18, you're graduating, right? Because you need that kind of closure in your high school career, you know, and to really be now out in the real world and, you know, taking on those kind of responsibilities.
About class of 2020 graduating, those are actually the, you know, those are the ones that pediatricians would be probably, you know, they would be focused on for sure, right?
Right.
But least less focused on,
sure,
because
middle schoolers,
they have had time to develop.
Right.
Because keep in mind, education does not just teach, it does not just teach math, science, English, whatever. It teaches
interpersonal skills, teaches social skills,
right?
I mean,
emotional skills. It teaches,
right? What's your place going to be in society?
Yeah. I think LAUSD, I think, has gone the political route instead of the scientific route, instead of actually looking into the psychology, the importance of children being in schools and all this stuff. Before they reopen schools, LAUSD, they were announcing that they want to implement a wealth tax, defund the police, have state-funded housing for the homeless, suspend private schools. Okay, if that's not clearly a political play, then I don't really know what is. Because I haven't heard too much about the children, and data is not showing that children are at risk from COVID. A child has a way greater chance of getting killed on the drive over to school than getting COVID and dying right now.
I would say that, yeah, it's true. There can be hidden political agendas, and it's very evident. But at the same time, I don't want to make myself sound ignorant.
You can take your time.
It's time to reopen schools. It's time to reopen schools and exercise our freedom. Open schools. Open schools.
Schools did not end up being the COVID hotspots that they were all thinking that it was going to be. So, Sweden, Denmark, Norway, Germany, all these places are going to be doing in-school teaching.
Yeah, I saw that.
And the reason for that is because the data just doesn't suggest that it's dangerous to open schools back up. Now, of course, when it comes to it, you should obviously still be social distancing. Anything to reduce risk, right? You and I both agree with that. And anything to reduce risk, we both agree with that. Distancing, keeping doors open so there's more air circulation, airflow, and all that stuff. This is just another little point, but when it comes to underprivileged children, the distance learning, it's not working. It doesn't work. They don't have, their parents don't have tutors that they can pay to help them understand what's going on. The parents might be, it might be a single parent at home and they don't have the time, or maybe they're just not a teacher.
Sure.
God forbid a parent doesn't know, you know, a biology class and help out with homework and stuff like that. These are problems.
There have been cases of kids who have gotten it.
Absolutely.
But it hasn't necessarily affected them as much as it has affected our older community. I think it's just scary territory because it's not, there's not a lot of information known about it.
You're correct.
So wanting to take the safest route makes sense to me to not take that risk, but at the same time, you're also taking away those resources from the kids to be able to go back to school.
I think you're gonna have to sacrifice some of the good things about having kids in school, in physical schooling, in order to just address this virus as it continues to ramp up.
The numbers also speak for themselves. Kids just don't transmit or get the virus easily. In the whole country, under the ages of 15 years old, in the whole country, you're looking at, what is it, 31 deaths of COVID in the entire country for children.
So I'm not familiar with the fact that children...
They have a greater chance of dying in a car accident going to school than they do getting COVID and dying in school.
I believe that they're more likely to die of a car accident. That's not the issue, though.
So should we stop driving on the way to school? Should they walk? Because if they walk, they would still have a greater chance of dying from walking to school than they would of COVID-19.
We're in agreement that they have a higher likelihood of dying from a car accident.
Now, when it comes to other negatives, it's not just because, believe me, when it comes to the ramifications of falling behind in school, it's not good, especially for children that are already struggling in tougher communities. But not just that, in 2018, and it's kind of similar to this annually, is in 2018 there were 678,000 reports of child abuse and neglect, right? Teachers, I'm sure you can imagine, are actually the largest group of individuals that report child abuse and neglect to local authorities, okay? So one scary thing that we're seeing right now is child abuse and neglect reports have plummeted by 40 to 50%, plummeted in March and April. The reason for that is because children are not being seen by coaches. They're not being seen by teachers. And these are very scary things.
Just break it up into shifts if you don't have the infrastructure or whatever, so that they're literally, you just do the social distancing thing where kids can sit, you know, for people who are uncomfortable about it or they're just not sure, you just maintain social distance, you can keep the school running. That's it.
So they have a huge, huge role in not just teaching children in person, because that's the best way to teach children. Not just that, not just children developing social and emotional skills on campuses and stuff, but they look out for children's safety as well.
That the kids will have going forward, because they're with them, it's like 60 to 70% of their time growing up until they're 18 years old.
So what are your thoughts on that? Child abuse and neglect reports plummeting right now. Is that not a nightmare? Is that not terrifying?
I mean, I would say you make a very good point, and I don't necessarily disagree with you, even if it might be one school year, or even just one semester of shutting down, as opposed to, I'm trying to like gather my...
Well, I'll let you think about that while I come follow up something, because you mentioned that. You say even if it's just a semester, okay, why is it anything? Do you have the same argument for the people that work over at Costco or Home Depot or working in these stores over here? Why is it anything? The data just doesn't really reflect what you're saying. We have workers at Costco, we have workers at grocery stores, we have workers at gas stations, and for some reason, education's just taking a backseat and saying, hey, pause it for 9 weeks, 10 weeks, whenever things start to calm down, even though they're not COVID hotspots, just in general.
I mean, there's ways around running education, whereas, you know, there are much tougher challenges for like replacing, for instance, gas station workers.
And I think teaching is very essential. I think you're a teacher. I think you're very essential. I think education for children is very essential. When it comes to, some teachers might not want to go into school to work,
right,
they can still do the online teaching.
The
great. Yeah, exactly.
You can do that. I mean, the only reason I would a little bit lay off of Zoom, it doesn't
appeal
to me.
I understand your point.
Like, can you imagine a six-year-old learning through? They're not learning.
You're
they're
totally
running
right.
around the house. They're, yeah. they're not going to.
Teaching children is essential. And when it comes to the risk of children, virtually zero. So what there needs to be a focus on is teachers doing their part to keep clean, wear masks like you and I are not right now, and just be careful not to transmit the disease. I don't see that any different than people working at grocery stores. If anything, teachers are just as important as the individual giving us our food, right?
Yeah, I think you make very good points. I would agree with you.
Okay. American Academy of Pediatrics, have you heard their stance on it?
I believe the American Academy of Pediatrics, as someone who's not a pediatrician, I think they had a statement recently saying that, you know, kids would lose, you know, a lot of the benefits by not being in school. But I don't know that they actually doubled down on saying they should all return to school right now.
So what they were saying is children need to get back into schools next month when school starts. They need to get back into schools. What they need to do is do it safely. What they said is, hey, approach it in a reasonable fashion, right? Distance children to the best of your abilities, keep things clean for the teachers. The teachers need to be watching out for other teachers because adults obviously at this point transmit the virus more from what we've seen than children. They carry it more than children. But they do believe as a whole that they need to get kids back in school. Actually, it's kind of funny. NBC the other day had five pediatricians that they picked to come on and give their feedback. 5 out of 5 supported going back for in-school learning. So
our kids are not being affected. It's not a situation where we gotta protect our kids and protect our children from the good old coronavirus. You know, it's not the evil monster when it comes to kids. So let them go back to school. Let them get their education and do what they gotta do to succeed.
If I'm the president, why would I sacrifice my election and say, let's send all these kids back to school. Let's get all the kids sick. Let's let these kids die off. And then, okay, you know what? Come November, everybody vote for me. I did this for these kids. You're gonna lose the election if all these kids end up dying. So when Trump said, hey, let's open back schools, there has to be something going on to be like, if Trump feels like we can open up schools again, then why not? If it's not that serious to these kids, if it's not that detrimental to these kids, then guess what? It's probably not that detrimental to people that don't have any underlying issues. It's definitely detrimental to those that are underprivileged. It's definitely detrimental to those that, I wouldn't even say, it's
detrimental to everyone. It's bad for everyone.
It's bad for everyone. Correct.